But does homeopathy really work? This question has sparked many debates across the globe. Homeopathy, a 200-year-old system of alternative medicine, has stirred up controversies with its principles of like cures like and minimum dose. Its philosophy revolves around stimulating the body's self-healing capabilities using substances that in larger quantities would produce symptoms of the ailment. Critics, however, question its efficacy and scientific validity. With that said, let's delve deeper into this topic and explore both sides. First, we'll examine the viewpoint of those who stand by homeopathy as an effective form of medicine. Homeopathy has a strong legion of supporters who swear by its benefits, and their faith is often rooted in personal experience. Many recount stories of chronic ailments that conventional medicine failed to alleviate, only to find relief in the gentle touch of homeopathic remedies. These individual testimonials, filled with heartfelt conviction, form the bedrock of homeopathy's support. Then there's the philosophical allure of homeopathy. The central concept of like cures like resonates with many. This principle suggests that a substance causing symptoms in a healthy person can, when presented in diluted form, cure similar symptoms in a sick person. It's a fascinating idea, one that challenges conventional modes of thinking about medicine and health. Finally, homeopathy's holistic approach is another major draw for its supporters. Unlike conventional medicine, which often focuses on treating the disease, homeopathy aims to treat the person. This means considering not just physical symptoms, but emotional and mental states as well. Homeopathy views health as a complex interplay of mind, body, and spirit, and its remedies seek to restore balance across these realms. These are the core beliefs that fuel the unwavering faith of homeopathy's supporters. They see it not just as an alternative, but as a fundamentally different and perhaps better way to achieve health and wellness. While these arguments hold weight for many, critics of homeopathy have a different perspective. Now, let's examine the counter-arguments. Critics of homeopathy challenge its effectiveness for several reasons. To begin with, a major reason skeptics question homeopathy is due to the lack of solid scientific evidence. Many argue that most homeopathic studies lack the rigor and control of conventional medical research. They point out that there are few, if any, large-scale, randomized double-blind trials, the gold standard in medical research, that show homeopathy's effectiveness. Another common criticism is the placebo effect. This is the phenomenon where a patient feels better after receiving treatment, but not because of the treatment itself. Instead, it's their belief in the treatment that makes them feel better. Critics argue that homeopathy's effectiveness may be largely attributed to this placebo effect, rather than any therapeutic properties of the remedies themselves. Lastly, the concept of ultra-diluted remedies is a contentious point. Homeopathic remedies are often diluted to such an extent that there may not be a single molecule of the original substance left. Critics argue that it's scientifically implausible for these ultra-diluted remedies to have any biological effect, let alone a therapeutic one. They contend that it contradicts the known laws of physics and chemistry. So with these contrasting views, where does that leave us? In the end, the effectiveness of homeopathy, like many forms of alternative medicine, often boils down to personal belief and experience. We've delved into the perspectives of both supporters and critics of homeopathy. On one hand, we've seen the adamant proponents who vouch for the potential of homeopathy, citing personal experiences, documented cases, and the long-standing history of this medical approach that dates back well over 200 years. On the other hand, we've heard from the critics who question the scientific validity of homeopathy. They argue that many of the principles it is based on are not in line with the laws of chemistry and physics, and that the positive experiences some people report can often be attributed to the placebo effect. In the midst of this ongoing debate, it's crucial to remember the importance of informed decision-making when it comes to health and wellness. It's not about blindly accepting or rejecting a form of treatment. It's about understanding what it entails its potential benefits and risks, and how it aligns with your personal health needs and beliefs. Health is not a one-size-fits-all concept. What works for one person may not work for another. As we navigate through the sea of information and opinions, it's essential to consult with professionals, weigh the pros and cons, and make an informed choice. While the debate on homeopathy's effectiveness continues, one thing remains certain: the choice is ultimately yours. Do your research, consult with professionals, and make the decision that feels right for you.